Hey everyone, this is Anam Chahar. Welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, I'll be discussing the summary of lesson number 8, Midgebill the Otter, from the book First Flight of class 10. The chapter is based on the theme that keeping a pet is a serious responsibility, especially when the pet is an unusual animal like an otter. Otter means udbilao. They are water animals. Yes, they can survive on land also, but they like being in water the most. The author, Gavin Maxwell, was an animal lover. Through this account, he has shared his experiences with his new pet, which is an otter, with the readers. In 1956, Gavin Maxwell traveled to Iraq. He had recently lost his dear dog, Johnny. His pet dog, Johnny, had recently died, so he was heartbroken. He wanted to have a new pet to fill in the void left by his dog, Johnny. But he was too sad to keep another dog, so he thought about experimenting to keep an otter as a pet. Otters, as you can see in the picture, they are water animals. Maxwell used to live in Camasferna. He used to live in a place called Camasferna, which was surrounded by water bodies. So it appeared to be a suitable place for keeping this water animal. So he decided that he is going to have an otter as a pet. He discussed his idea with one of his friends who had accompanied him to Iraq. He was traveling with him to Iraq. His friend advised Maxwell to find an otter from the Tigris marshes, a place that had countless otters, often tamed by Arabs. So a lot of Arabs, they lived in that place and they used to keep otters as pet. So he gave him an advice that he can get one from there. After some days, Maxwell and his friend went to Basra, to the consulate general, to collect and answer their mails from Europe. So like I said, the story is based in 1956. So in those days, internet connections and these things were not there. So both Maxwell and his friend had to travel to a place called Basra to get their mails from Europe, because right now they were in Iraq. By chance, his friend's mail had arrived, but Maxwell had to wait for his mail for another 5 days. He had to stay at Basra for another 5 days. So his friend left. When Maxwell returned with his mail, after collecting his mail from the consulate general's office, when one day he came back to his hotel room, he found two Arabs waiting for him. Two people were waiting for him. They handed him a note from his friend which said, "Here is your otter." The otter was in a sack. So these two people, they were carrying a sack. Sack means a large bag. So they handed him the note given by his friend as well as the bag containing the otter. When Maxwell opened the sack, he saw an otter that looked like a small dragon. His body was smeared with mud. Smeared with means covered with. Maxwell says that it took him a month to remove all the traces of mud and dirt from its chocolate-colored body. He named the otter Midgebill. So he also gave him a name. He started calling him Midgebill. Since it was a new place for Midgebill, he remained aloof during the first 24 hours. Aloof means he did not get along with anyone. He was just quiet, sitting alone. He slept on the floor and remained as far as possible from Maxwell. However, he soon became quite friendly, and the very next day, he jumped into Maxwell's bed and slept with him. So he was a very friendly animal. Although he took 24 hours, but then he became very friendly. Next day, Maxwell led him to the bathroom. Since otters are water animals, so the sight of the water brought immense joy to Midgebill. He became very happy. He jumped in the bathtub and started enjoying himself. He started jumping in the bathtub, he started rolling, he started having fun. While doing so, he created a lot of mess. By observing Midgebill's behavior in water, Maxwell learned that playing with water is a feature of otters. They love to splash water around them. They love to splash water and they cannot resist it. After 2 days, Maxwell was surprised to see that Midgebill had managed to get into the bathroom all by himself, and he had also learned to turn the tap with his paws. So he had learned to open the tap on his own without anybody's help. This shows that he was very intelligent. He soon learned many things and started responding to his name. Whenever the author called him Midgebill, he would respond to his name. Midgebill was a playful pet. He enjoyed playing with a rubber ball, dribbling it all over the room and throwing it up powerfully to a great distance. At times, he would lie on his back and roll 2 or more marbles on his belly without letting them fall off his body. So he was very playful. He used to play all these games. He used to play with marbles and with a rubber ball. So far they had been staying in Basra. Now it was time for them to leave Basra. Maxwell was worried about transporting his pet otter to England. Now he was very worried how to transport Midgebill from Iraq to England. All the British airlines to London, all the airlines directly from Iraq to London, any airline did not allow animals. British airline did not allow animals. So Maxwell had to book a flight via France. From Iraq, first he had to go to France, and then from France he went to London. Even this flight from France to London, they asked Maxwell to put Midgebill in a box. The otter was required to be put in an 18 by 18 inches box to be placed on the floor at the passenger's feet. So Maxwell got this box ready and put Midgebill into it an hour before leaving for the airport, just to familiarize him so that he doesn't feel awkward. He doesn't feel out of place. To familiarize him with this box, he put Midgebill inside the box 1 hour before they had to leave for the airport. Then Maxwell went to have a quick meal. However, on his return, he was shocked to see that the otter had badly ripped the inner lining of the box and injured himself. Midgebill was bleeding. When Maxwell came back after having his meal, he saw that Midgebill had destroyed the inner lining of the box and he was bleeding. It took Maxwell a long time to remove the shredded lining of the box. He then put Midgebill back into the box. After repairing the box, he again put him inside the box and made the driver of his car rush to the airport at the bullet's speed. as he was already getting late. And somehow he managed to reach there in time. On reaching there, he found the aircraft waiting for him to take off. The officials were angry with him. However, Maxwell felt lucky as he had been booked a seat at the extreme front as he needed more space to place the box containing Mitchell. He covered the floor around his feet with newspapers. So after taking his seat, he started making arrangements to keep the box containing Mitchell. So he covered the space with newspapers and he shared his worries about Mitchell with the air hostess. She was a kind lady. She suggested to try carrying the pet on his knees. She suggested him to take out Mitchell from the box and he could carry it on his knees. Maxwell was very happy with the suggestion, but he did not know that an otter out of the box could be difficult to manage. As soon as Max opened the box and Mitchell came out, he created a lot of confusion and panic among the passengers. It wasn't easy to get him back to his place. He started jumping here and there. But fortunately, after some time, he returned on his own and he came back to Maxwell. Finally, they reached London. Mitchell lived with Maxwell in his flat in London for nearly a month. Mitchell would keep himself busy. He would keep himself busy and entertained with different toys like ping pong balls, marbles, rubber fruits, etc. Sometimes he would also invent his own games. Mitchell used to understand all the commands of Maxwell just like a dog. Like I said, he also invented his own games. This shows that he was very intelligent and smart. Every day, the author would take him for a walk. While doing this, like when they used to go for a walk, Mitchell developed some compulsive habits while walking with his master. So Maxwell, on the streets of London, whenever they would go for a walk, Mitchell would follow the same routine every day. Compulsive habits means doing the same things again and again, following the routine over and over again. So every day he would repeat the same things. And what was the same thing? He would jump on the low wall of a primary school. Just near to his house, there was a primary school. So while walking, Mitchell would jump on the wall and he would run the full length of 30 yards at high speed. This would distract the students as well as the teachers. Maxwell also came to know that an average Londoner is unfamiliar with otters. The people who were living in London at that time, most of them were unfamiliar with otters. When he would go for a walk with Mitchell, most of the people couldn't recognize the animal. They made wild guesses about Mitchell's species. They had never seen an otter before. Some thought it to be a baby seal. Seal is an animal. So some thought it was a baby seal, while others thought it to be a squirrel. Some guessed that it was a walrus, a bear cub, a leopard, and some even called him a hippopotamus. Once, a laborer who was digging a hole in the street laid down his tool, stared at Mitchell and inquired from Maxwell, "What is that supposed to be?" So this shows that people were not familiar with otters. They did not recognize Mitchell. So yeah, that's all about it. From this account, we get to know that it's not an easy task to look after a pet, to keep a pet. it's a huge responsibility and it requires a lot of effort. So that's all about it. If you like the video, if you found it useful, then please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. You can also leave comments on the video. Thank you.